Lower respiratory tract infections caused by respiratory syncytial virus, or RSV, send thousands of babies to the hospital every year. The U.S. Food and Drug Administration approved a new drug, a monoclonal antibody called Nirsevimab, that protects infants from severe RSV infections. Norsevumab is the second antibody to be approved in the U.S. for this purpose, though, compared to the other option, confers longer-lasting protection with a single dose and has been approved for use in a broader range of infants. But how and how well does this antibody work? When will it become available for clinical use? What other tools are being developed to prevent severe RSV infections as the next RSV season looms large? Welcome to Microbial Minutes, the American Society for Microbiology's update on what's hot in the microbial sciences. I'm Madeline Barron, Science Communications Specialist at ASM. So let's start with some background. RSV is an enveloped single-stranded RNA virus that spreads via respiratory droplets or through contaminated surfaces. Anyone can become infected by RSV, though children are especially vulnerable to infection, and most people will be infected by the time they are 2 years old. Symptoms associated with RSV infection can be cold-like, for example, a runny nose or a cough, and are often self-limiting. However, RSV can cause lower respiratory tract disease that generally presents as bronchiolitis or pneumonia, which can make breathing difficult, especially in infants. Infants who are born prematurely or who have certain health conditions, such as chronic lung disease, are particularly at risk for RSV lower respiratory tract infections. Though, according to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, all infants less than 6 months of age are at risk for severe disease. In fact, 20 to 30% of infants will develop RSV lower respiratory tract disease with their first infection, resulting in up to 80,000 hospitalizations and 300 deaths in the U.S. every year. Treatment for RSV consists only of supportive care, such as managing fever, oxygen, and fluids. Now, the U.S. has yearly seasonal outbreaks of RSV that generally begin in November and last until about March. However, last year's RSV season was especially concerning. The spike in cases was substantially higher than previous years. For example, the CDC reported over 20,000 positive RSV PCR tests in mid-November 2022, up from just over 4,000 from the same time in 2021. This increase, which scientists tied to a lifting in COVID-19 precautions that had limited exposure to all respiratory viruses, put a significant strain on healthcare systems and families. It is with this particularly nasty RSV season in the rearview mirror and a new season approaching that has provided an even greater incentive to develop tools for preventing severe infections in infants in the first place. To that end, there is one drug that is available for preventing severe RSV lower respiratory tract infections in infants, though it is specific for high-risk babies, that is, those born prematurely or are less than 6 months of age at the beginning of the RSV season. The drug, palivizumab, sold under the brand name Synagis, is an antibody that binds to the fusion protein on the RSV virus to prevent it from fusing with host cells. It is not a vaccine, which stimulates the body's own immune system to make antibodies. Rather, these are ready-made antibodies to immediately confer protection against the pathogen, a process known as passive immunity. Yet, the antibody has a short half-life and is administered monthly starting just before and then during RSV season. And though it does prevent high-risk babies from being hospitalized with RSV and is therefore an important tool in the toolbox, it only does so about 45 to 55% of the time, according to two trials in which the drug's efficacy was tested as the primary endpoint. The newest antibody approved by the FDA overcomes some of the limitations of palivizumab. The antibody, called Nirsevimab, branded as Beyfortus, has been approved by the FDA for prevention of RSV lower respiratory tract infections in neonates and infants born during or entering their first RSV season. It is also approved for use in children up to 24 months old who remain vulnerable to severe disease through their second season. Thus, Nirsevimab is approved for a broader spectrum of infants, regardless of when they were born or if they have underlying health conditions. Moreover, compared to the monthly injections required for Synagis, Nirsevimab is administered via a single intramuscular injection that can provide protection throughout the RSV season. This longer-lasting protection is tied to the structure of the antibody and how it interacts with the virus. Specifically, Nirsevimab also binds the RSV fusion protein, but it does so at a different site than palivizumab, one that may make it more effective long-term. In addition, modifications to the amino acid sequence of the antibody help extend its half-life and promote greater stability. So how well does Nirsevimab work? The safety and efficacy of the antibody were tested in three clinical trials, two of which included efficacy as a primary endpoint. In these trials, efficacy was defined as the incidence of RSV lower respiratory tract infections 150 days post-dose that required a visit to the doctor, known as medically attended RSV lower respiratory tract infections. Some of the details of those trials are shown here. In the first, preterm infants who received Nirsevimab had about a 70% lower risk of developing medically attended RSV lower respiratory tract disease compared to those in the placebo group. They also exhibited about a 78% lower risk of hospitalization. Similar results were seen in the second study, which included late preterm and term infants. In this case, there was about a 74.9% relative risk reduction for RSV lower respiratory tract disease requiring medical care, and a reduction in hospitalization risk of about 60%. The third trial was designed to measure safety and pharmacokinetics of Nirsevimab in infants for high-risk RSV lower respiratory tract infections, with efficacy as a secondary measurement. The results of this study were favorable for use of the antibody in this population. The most common side effects from the antibody were relatively mild and included rash and injection site reactions that could be treated. Nirsevimab is expected to become available ahead of the 2023-2024 RSV season. Before then, the Advisory Committee on Immunization Practices, a group of experts that advises the CDC on appropriate administration of vaccines and related agents, like antibodies, needs to determine who the drug should be recommended for. However, draft recommendations are in place and are expected to be approved and formalized soon. The FDA approval of Nirsevimab is a key development toward preventing severe RSV infection, though there are other advancements worth touching on. For example, in May, the FDA approved vaccines by the pharmaceutical companies GSK and Pfizer for prevention of RSV lower respiratory tract disease in individuals 60 years or older, another high-risk group. The European Medicines Agency also approved Pfizer's vaccine for protection of severe RSV in infants when administered to pregnant women. In this case, the mother produces antibodies in response to the vaccine, which can then pass through the placenta to the fetus to confer immunity to the virus. In a phase 3 double-blind trial, maternal vaccination was shown to be about 82% effective at preventing severe RSV illness in infants during the first 90 days of life, and 69.4% the first 6 months of life. An advisory panel to the FDA recommended the vaccine is effective for use in pregnant women in May, and the FDA is expected to decide whether the vaccine can be used for pregnant women in the U.S. in August. So let's recap what we've discussed today. RSV is the most common cause of severe lower respiratory tract disease in infants. And there is an antibody, palivizumab, that keeps high-risk babies out of the hospital about 50% of the time. The short half-life of this antibody, however, means it must be administered monthly during the RSV season. Nirsevimab, the latest antibody to be approved by the FDA, reduces risk of medically attended RSV lower respiratory tract disease by about 70% and requires only one injection for the RSV season. It has been approved for a broader range of infants, though we do not yet know the recommendations for which infants it will be specifically used for. Finally, additional preventive tactics, including maternal RSV vaccines, are also on the horizon, which would further expand options for protecting babies from severe RSV infection. And that's all for today. Be sure to subscribe to ASM's YouTube channel to be notified whenever a new Microbial Minutes drops. I'm Madeline Barron, and I want to thank you for listening. Thank Ray Ortega for production, and I'll talk to you soon.